Whitewater Brewing Company Midnight Stout. It's an oatmeal milk stout from the Ottawa Valley in Ontario. And this fine coaster that it's sitting on is also from the Ottawa Valley area in Ontario. How convenient. Look, it's a pile of mail. Starting with this one, which has a Mississauga, Ontario return address, but I'm pretty sure that is just a drop shipping warehouse near the airport in Mississauga. Hello, a tool. What tool is this? Oh, this is a spring-loaded center punch. So for when you're drilling a hole in something, you want a starter divot or dimple or whatever. And these spring-loaded center punches do that, or allegedly do that. This one didn't see. Well, it did make a couple of divots in that thin little metal there. So what is supposed to happen, and I'm not really hearing it happen. There you go. There it happened once. We'll see if we can do it again. Hear that thump? There's a little mechanism inside here that is supposed to over-center and slam that punch somehow. Let's see if we can figure it out. Oh, I think there's another spring up there too. There is. There's a heavy spring up there. And there's a weight. Okay. So let's just arrange this here. So there is the basic exploded diagram. So, So that goes up there, and that goes down there, and that goes there. So how does that over-center and hammer? Or does it? Does it just go up here? I forgot already. So why does that trip that little hammer to drop in there? There's a hollow in this. I'm not quite sure how this works. Oh, okay. That hollow in there is actually tapered. I'm not sure whether you can see that happening or not. So that drives up into it. Oh, does it go up at an angle and then, So it appears that goes up through that little tapered hole and pushes this up. And then when it gets high enough, it slips in and this guy slams down based on the heavier spring that's behind it. That's interesting. I never knew how one of these worked because I never owned one before. That's how it's supposed to work. Hear that thump? Okay, and it is leaving some divots on the outside of that. Okay, so I guess it'll do its job. Automatic center punch, marking, stamping, punching holes, power tools, woodworking. I got this from Happy Easy Buy 04. They're currently selling it for $5.60 and some shipping I paid back in April. I paid $2.96 and this took about 20 days to get here. So yeah, the benefit of this type of automatic center punch rather than the old school one is this right here. You can do it one-handed. Any center punch will do the rest of these things pretty much. But yeah, being able to center punch without with just a single hand while you're holding your marking tools or whatever in the other hand, that is the benefit. All right, next thing in, we have a plastic sheet and modules. Ooh, two things in one. What do we have here? We have what looks like two modules. So the first one is for the Wemos D1 Mini. It is a triple base. Basically, it is just a shield multiplier, I guess. The pins are all connected in parallel all the way across the three, so that you can basically just connect three different shields up, or two shields and a D1 Mini at the same time, without having to resort to stacking your headers on top of each other and going up high. Although most D1 Mini shields and D1 Minis themselves come with double height stacking headers anyway. This kind of headers. So these things are designed so that you can use them this way, right? You put one there and stack another one on top like that. And depending, well, maybe not this relay one, but for most types of shields, you can just go two or three deep. But things like the relay shield, which are a little bit thicker, get in the way of that. However, for this, you can put the D1 on one, say, I don't know, a temperature sensor and a relay module side by each, or two relay modules, or whatever you want. And that way, you can just get access to them, and they're not fouled, and you can, if there's an adjustment to be made, you can make the adjustment. And it comes with six headers to fully populate it. Neat. Dual triple shield Node MCU Lua Mini Wemos D1 Mini IoT ESP8266 Arduino Shield. Wow, it's like keyword jumbles again. Obviously, D1 Mini and Triple Shield are the important keywords here. Got this from Gowin Electronic. Back when I bought it in February, it was $1.43. Now it's come up a little bit to $1.79. There are other sellers that have it for better shipping, or, of course, if you're in a different country. What do they say? For some shields, it's important that they operate in parallel, like a display shield or push button. Yeah, okay, that's even a better example than what I came up with off the cuff. I think that's going to come in handy for some tinkering and experimenting at some point in the future. And the other thing in the package, also obviously from Gowin Electronic, we have 5 volts and ground, another 5 volt LED up there. We have motor AB, SLP, MS1, ground step direction, enable, ground and motor voltage plus. There it is right there. This is an easy driver. This is a little stepper driver. And apparently, based on the name, it is easier to use than some others. What do we have here? We have a current limit adjustment. We have a voltage regulator. And then the main chip, which is an A3967 SLBT. Okay, I assume that is a stepper motor driver chip. What else would it be? One piece new, easy driver, shield, stepping, stepper, motor driver, V44, A3967 for Arduino. And yeah, that's the chip number that we saw on there. I got this from Gowin Electronic. I got it at auction back in February. I paid $1.77 at auction, of course, with free shipping, because I always pay free shipping if I have any choice. The Easy Driver is a simple-to-use stepper motor driver compatible with anything that can output a digital 0-5 pulse or 3.3 pulse if you solder a jumper. MS1 and MS2 pins broken out to change micro-stepping between full, half, quarter, and eighth steps. Compatible with 4, 6, and 8-wire stepper motors of any voltage. Oh, cool. Any voltage up to 30 volts, anyway. The higher the voltage, the higher the torque. Well, that could be interesting to play with. What is the next thing in? Expansion board module. That's definitely a module. And what do we have here? Looks like some sort of an antenna, judging by that connector there. And what do we have on there? It is a GPS module. Looks like it receives and transmits data, so that speaks UART. That's interesting. That should be kind of fun to play with. I mean, I've got a few other GPS things, obviously my phone, but from geocaching days, I've got a couple of handheld GPS units as well. So I wonder if I would be able to use this somehow related to geocaching. One piece GYNE06MV2 module GPS Neo 6M etc. board with antenna for Arduino. I bought this from our old friend Alice1101983, who doesn't sell anything GPS right at this particular time. Back in March when I bought it, I paid $5.56 for it though. But I will link you to this search that'll find a bunch of them. Anyway, let's look at just a random seller's listing. It has a ceramic clad antenna. It is an EEPROM to save configuration. It speaks at 9600 baud. And again, over UART serial. And actually, if it's speaking UART, then I should be able to connect it up to a CH340 or something like that and read its packets on the computer. It has some play potential, this thing. Though I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to play with this thing on video without giving away my location. Okay, next thing is 20 pieces, 4-pin, female. That's surprisingly descriptive. Is it accurate, though? This is some stackable female header pins. And these, oh, we saw some of these in the D1 Mini collection. So these are designed to go onto a board, such as this random piece of circuit board that I happen to have here. You can solder it on there. Then you can plug that down into breadboard or whatever. And then another module can plug on top. And if you've got them designed well, you can just keep on going. Now, why did I order these particular ones? There was an application that I needed extra long header pins and didn't have them. So I stole some from some of the D1 mini kits. That's probably what it was. 20 pieces, 4-pin, female, tall, stackable header connector socket for Arduino Shield. I got these from Survey 2014 for the princely sum of $2.34. Again, back when I ordered these in March, it was free shipping. These only took 23 days to get here. Not much to say down here. Single row, female, 4-pin, 2.54mm pitch, 20 of them. And the last thing, which is coincidentally the largest package, module. I'm wondering what kind of a module is this big. It's not a module at all. It is a kit. Woohoo! And a big kit, too. Let's see what all this stuff is. So it looks like we got a template. That's pretty funkadelic. We have a circuit board with presumably a microcontroller on it. No clues as to the name of it yet. Oh, it comes with a serial, USB to serial adapter. Interesting. What I'm seeing in here is a whole stack of LEDs, which makes sense with that template up there. Uh-oh. That's a lot of LEDs. Oh wow, there's a lot going on here. We have an STC microcontroller, we have a USB cable, we have a 3.5mm jack, we have some wire, we have a remote control. Wow. Just a generic little cheapy remote control. Then there's some resistors and got an infrared receiver and a couple of 5mm LEDs and some standoffs. That could be that's going to be an interesting and time-consuming kit to put together with all of these LEDs in it. Just curious. blue LED. Oh, color changing LEDs. Wow. Okay. Let's go find the listing for this guy. This didn't come from eBay. This came from IC Station. This is colorful LED tower display rhythm lamp lights with infrared remote control, electronic DIY kits, brain training toy gifts. Wow. Currently selling for $12.33 in US dollars. Oh, okay. On IC Station's own website. I'm trying to diversify my purchasing just a little bit. Yeah, I know it's still China, but the LED tower is imitated from the Guangzhou Tower in China, I guess. Tallest building in Guangzhou. Okay. That looks like an interesting spiral of LEDs. That's a lot of them. It uses an STC12CA60S2 as a control system. The display part is basically a 16 by 16 dot matrix display. Oh, okay. Just wrapped around in a funky shape. The finished tower size is 90 by 78 by 450 millimeters. 45, half a meter tall? Wow. 16 by 16 lattice, offers animation modes, music spectrum mode. And there is a rough schematic. So 16 by 16 matrix. Okay. So does that mean that this guy's got... Oh, it's a 40-pin IC. So maybe it does have 32 GPIO pins. There's 16 up there. And there's 16 down there. Yeah, wow. Okay, it's got more than that because it's also got, where's the IR receiver? There's an IR receiver that's got to be connected to here somewhere. Maybe that connector is the IR receiver, or maybe that one. How many LEDs do we have in here? There's 4 5-millimeter LEDs, colorful, which means I assume those are color changing as well. And then there are 271 3-millimeter LEDs. Oh, if I remember correctly, shortly after I did that LED cube kit that had intimidated me up until I built it. Shortly after I did that one, I decided to double down and challenge myself and ordered this thing. I hope I don't regret it. Well, there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul, and quite the variety it is. Tools to add to my shop over by my clunky cheap-ass drill press. That's going to come in handy for playing with the D1 minis once the rest of the shields and things that I've ordered come in. Easy stepper driver. I've played with stepper motors in the past and stepper drivers, but this one I think is a different one that I haven't seen before, so I figured I'd grab that to play with. Shop stock, of course. The GPS module could be interesting to maybe just for clip it onto the dog's collar and see how far he goes at the dog park, or how fast he goes even. And then there's this kit. Wow, that's going to be interesting to put together. It said it's almost half a meter tall. This is much less than half a meter. Out here too. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do that exactly on camera. That's probably the least of my challenges with it. Just doing the mechanical stuff and getting all those hundreds of LEDs in place. But it's going to look impressive as hell when I'm done, I'm sure. Anyway, wow. Thanks for watching, everybody. That was quite the interesting haul. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters for helping me fill up the mailbag every couple of Mondays. And thanks once again to viewers like you. Talk to you later.